Is Joan Pereira?
Mr. Speaker, sir, with the trend of more new types of drugs produced, trafficked, and sold in increasing quantities, it is important that we increase the penalties for drug offenders to act as an effective deterrent. However, such deterrence alone is not sufficient, as we can still see these activities going on with impudence despite the harsh penalties. We will also need to consider how we can successfully flush out such syndicates operating in the region and their distribution channels into Singapore. This is not easy, as many of the syndicates are based overseas and their masterminds are also not within our jurisdiction. I hope that we can have even closer cooperation with our bilateral counterparts, such as the various platforms within ASEAN that deal specifically with this issue, including the meetings of the ASEAN senior officials on drug matters. The UN had repeatedly appealed to governments, especially those in Asia, to consider the problem of the abuse of and trafficking in amphetamine-type stimulants in their entirety, including their prevalence and the reasons why more youths in the region are turning to the abuse of methamphetamine. This problem is a regional issue, and every country has a part to play in slowing down this drug epidemic. Are there regional information sharing partnerships that can be enhanced? Can Singapore play a role in committing some resources to such efforts? There are also shifting attitudes among governments in the region towards drugs, including some showing more tolerance or even acceptance of recreational users for selected types of drugs, like cannabis. This will invariably undermine existing efforts as the attitudes of youth in the region towards drugs will also shift. With the advent of new psychoactive substances, we are not simply saddled with a drug issue, but it also translates into community mental health issues. Studies have also shown that substance abuse and mental health issues are often co-occurring disorders, and abusers require longer-term support, treatment, and guidance in order to have a better chance at rehabilitation. Therefore, can I request for more comprehensive and longer-term mental health resources and support for drug abusers who have gone through rehabilitation? Sir, in Mandarin. 随着新化和致幻药的出现，我们不仅背负着毒品问题，还转换为社区心理健康问题。 研究还显示，药物滥用和精神健康问题往往是同时发生的疾病。滥用者需要更长期的支持、治疗和指导，才能有更好的康复机会。因此，我可否要求更全面、更长远的心理健康资源和支持，帮助戒毒康复者。I support the bill. Thank you.